It took me like 10, 15 minutes. I don't know what happened. It just went, fell on me. Okay. I was walking like this, okay? I put the foundation in here. And then it just went blanked. It went blank. And then it was asking me to update, I think. Or I just tried to find a way to like, to go back on live, because I just couldn't seem to do it. Okay, let me invite a few people. Okay, this is part two. Anyways, all right. We'll see if anyone is gonna jump on. You can always watch replay. So what happened earlier was just that, you know, I think like Facebook needed an update and I didn't update it. And then it didn't let me finish my live. It keeps blinking on and said, try connecting or something like that, and you know, can't connect. And then once I tried to connect, you know, I went to Apple and it couldn't go back on for some reason. So, ฉันหวัดดีจ้า เล่นแต่งหน้ากับพี่ไหม So, okay, we're back on before it goes crazy again. So you warm up your botanical foundation on your wrist. พี่เต้นหวัดดีค่ะพี่เต้นมันหลุดเพราะอะไรไม่รู้ And then, you know, I usually use my ring finger to kind of dab it. I used to do a lot more on my forehead, and I realized it's just a little too much, and it looks all patchy, all blotchy. So I start doing less on my forehead, okay? And then you kind of like just do it, you know, all over. This is how I do it. You do it however you want, but this is how I do it after I warm it on my wrist, because I have a friend who lives in San Francisco. It's cold year-round. If you don't know how the weather is like in San Francisco, it's just cold and foggy year-round. And so, you know, she opened it up and she's like, it's so dry. You know, like my foundation is so dry, and I can't seem to kind of like get it out of the jar, the little box, you know, like, I don't know what you call this. So this is what I do. I kind of like, you know, kind of like bought it, what you call it, like dab it all over my face, and I used my buffer brush to kind of brush it all around. You can just start with one section too. You see, like, so little goes a long way with botanical foundation. I think I might have used too much. So you go like that all over, okay? Yeah, so, and then I told her, I gave her a few troubleshoots that she could try, you know, with it. I'm like, well, try dry sponge, try wet sponge, because, you know, each method works differently with, you know, different people, different person, and different skin type. So this is what I do. Sometimes I do this in the car. Don't try that at home. Once in a while, I'm like, I'm so late, I do this, you know, I don't even look at myself, I just wipe my brush in the car, like that, okay? So actually right now, Shinto one is a little bit too light on my skin, because it's summertime, I've been in the sun, but, you know, it still works pretty well. Sometimes I mix it with Shinto 2, which is a shade darker. It goes in circular motion under the eyes. Sometimes I even try Olive 1, which is a little more peach undertone. This is yellow undertone. Okay, you do that. I should have done one side first, huh? So you can see the difference of how it works on each side. มาแล้วแม่ปอมาทันมั้ยเนี่ยเมื่อกี้นี่พี่แดบอย่างนี้นะพี่แดบไปทั่วหน้าแล้วพี่ก็เอาอีบัฟเฟอร์บรัชเนี่ยมา เอาไปทั่วแม่ปอใช้แม่ปอใช้นิ้วได้นะลูกเอานิ้วแดบถูเลยพี่เพื่อนใช้นิ้วเหมือนกันพี่มีเพื่อนใช้นิ้วเหมือนกันพี่มีเพื่อนใช้สปันจ์เนี่ยก็ใช้อย่างนี้ถูไปเรื่อยๆ so this foundation will give you that glowy and natural look okay so if you want that healthy natural look and this foundation is non-comedogenic which doesn't clog your pores so it sits on your skin it doesn't go in your skin so so it doesn't go in your skin doesn't seeps in your pores it sits on your skin so in this way it doesn't cause any zits any acne you know so that's a good way to do it because yeah and then you know with like setting spray and primer it would help you know last having it long lasting on your skin as well so that's pretty much it okay so that's the foundation so if you saw earlier I have my skin was a little bit darker you know before I applied the foundation and now it's a little lighter and that's how I like it my skin on my face is more red my neck is more yellow so what I try to do and when I try to like when people want to order foundation what I ask them is what they want to achieve because some people like to match the neck and the face sometimes like to go with their natural color on the face and sometimes they just want totally different from their normal shade I have a girl who's actually an olive one and she likes to be more pale so she ordered Gina Beach which is a little lighter and more pink you know so it's just like it's you play with it it's art so usually would I do that and if you see it here I have a little melasma and a little freckle I have a little melasma here it's kind of light now after the foundation is applied you can't really see it so I usually do apply my concealer so I usually use two colors to correct you know and to highlight so the highlight I use number zero is to kind of give the pop of the face when you put makeup on and to correct is to use my the color that is closest to my skin which is number three so usually I just like dab like that because it bugs me like I embrace my skin but like it bugs me to see those little imperfection you know like coming through my skin sometimes so I just use that with my skin I mean with my fingers and just dab it to hide my melasma and then I use this double as a little highlight sometimes so under the eyes it gives your skin that little smooth satin kind of like finish as well so you do that usually that's what I do like each day if I have time like today I didn't have time so I didn't put concealer on at all I just did my foundation my blush and then eyebrows and then eyeshadow okay so just like that and you can actually you know go on to apply your eyeshadow you know eyebrows your blush a little contour you know a little yeah contouring and a little shadow whatever you want to do so that's about it and this will give you that shine you will still see a little shine and that's how I like it you know if you want a little more matte then you use the translucent colorless powder to kind of like set it so it doesn't move and also it gives you the matte finish it's not as like shiny this is how I like it some people don't like it and the good news Lumlight Biocone is actually coming out with the finish spray that is oil control. So if you are oily skin, if you have oily skin, that is coming out very soon. And instead of just, no, it's not heavy at all. It's really light, you know, and when you wear it, you will see the coverage. It covers a lot of the imperfection that you have, like brown spots and aging spots. On your skin yet it's light as feather you know you don't feel heavy at all and doesn't get cakey if you want more coverage you go in the second layer with little amount again Okay, and yeah, and then you set it with the powder if you want it to be long lasting, and hopefully it doesn't give you that T-zone, shiny face, but it might, because it's summer right now. Like today when I came home, I have a little bit of the oily spot, but it wasn't too much. So try it, and remember, it's really highly pigmented. Try it a little bit at a time. If you want more coverage, go in the second layer, the third layer, or use concealer. It will help. So I know. So that's the skincare. I guess my friend was saying that, like she's having oily skin, and that's what we are trying to help her, improve the skin before moving on to the foundation and the makeup. Because like when you do a little art on the canvas, you need the canvas to be good and healthy first, and our skin is like canvas. So it needs, actually oily skin works better, with makeup than super dry skin, because like dry skin doesn't catch on any of the makeup at all, or like, it's harder. But with oily skin, it runs off easier. So hopefully the skincare would help control that for you. And then you can play around more with the makeup and the foundation. So that's it for the botanical foundation, and hopefully that helps. And try that at home, maybe tomorrow, whenever you want to try it, and give it a second try, third try, because sometimes, because it's new foundation, it's new makeup, you kind of need some time to get used to it. That's why I packed on a lot. For you, I think it should last you for like at least 4 or 5 applications. And yeah, talk to you later, sweetie. Go to bed, get your beauty sleep, and I'll catch up with you later, okay? Good night.